Dad, open the flap of my tent.
Hey, Darius, I need the backyard to set up for my birthday party.
I nodded. As Dad walked back to the house, I packed up my tent and placed my belongings in my black duffel bag. That night, Dad allowed me to sleep in his car that was parked in the garage. You may be wondering what type of parents would make their 16-year-old live in a tent in their backyard or even sleep in their car when they have a house. Well, honestly, I left my parents with no choice. Continue watching my story and you'll see what I mean. When I was about 15 years old, I wasn't allowed to go out with my friends unless chaperoned by one of my parents. While my other friends were able to enjoy life and date, I decided to stay at home. How embarrassing would it be if my parents were at the same table hanging out with my friends? My younger sister, Grace, didn't mind, but I wanted the freedom that my other friends had. I found that freedom with a group of older boys. I honestly can't remember how we began to hang together. I just remember we used to hang out a lot. But these boys lived in nicer neighborhoods than I did, and their parents were doctors and lawyers, so I was quite surprised when I realized the kind of things they did. As much as I wanted my freedom, this freedom came with choices and consequences which I didn't understand at the time. Anyway, my new friends embraced me, and to prove myself, I did everything that they wanted me to do, including skipping school. As long as I did everything they wanted, they got me new clothes and shoes and anything else that I wanted. Life was good.
Hey Dee, we're heading to the mall. Are you coming?
Blake asked as he approached me one morning as soon as I walked through the school gates. Yeah, sure. I fell into step with the other boys. While at the mall, Blake whispered to me.
Okay, it's your turn. See that black hoodie?
The one for $250?
Yup, that's the one. If you get that for me, I'll trade you my new sneakers that Mom got me.
I nodded and walked towards the rack. Even though I shoplifted a few times before, this was the one time when my life was changed because of it. I snuck into the dressing room and put on the hoodie under my sweater. As I was about to open the dresser door, I saw a little girl looking up at me from below the door. As I unlocked the door, she ran away and called out to her mom.
Mommy, Mommy, I saw that boy over there put on a hoodie under his clothes.
I tried to hustle out of the store before they identified who the little girl pointed towards, but I was caught by the security guard just before I stepped out of the door. Blake and the rest of the guys were rounded up after the security guard looked at the store security tape, and we were all taken to the holding center.
We've raised you better than this,
Mom said angrily as we walked out to the car. Mom and Dad took the rest of the day off to come bail me out of the mall. The owner was adamant that he would be pressing charges.
We don't have money for an expensive lawyer like your rich friends, Darius,
Dad said sternly as he hopped behind the wheel. During the hearing, Blake and the others were presented by one lawyer, the very prestigious Dwight Hansford, while I was represented by a legal aid lawyer who mixed up my hearing time with another client's. I was sent to 6 months in the youth detention facility while Blake and the others got 6 weeks of community service. Mom visited me every weekend, but Dad never did. Every weekend, Mom made an excuse that Dad had to work, but I didn't buy it. After 6 months, I came out and promised my parents that I would turn over a new leaf. However, as soon as I got a chance, I was back with my boys. When my parents found out, I was grounded for 2 months. That didn't stop me. I snuck out at night and returned before my parents woke up. This worked great until Grace caught me.
Where are you going?
She asked as I unlocked the front door. It's none of your business, I glared at her.
It may be none of my business, but I'm sure it would be Mom and Dad's business.
She smiled and she turned to head to their bedroom. I grabbed her arm and yanked it until she was facing me.
Ouch!
She pulled her hand away and rubbed it. You better not tell Mom and Dad. I clenched my fist.
Or what?
I slammed Grace against the wall and slapped her. She screamed out, which made Mom and Dad run from their room.
What is going on here?
Dad shouted as Mom comforted Grace. Grace told Mom and Dad what happened, and Dad added 3 more months to my punishment. I laughed. You really think you can keep me locked away in this house for 5 months? I opened the front door. Dad growled.
If you walk out this door, don't you dare walk back in!
I pulled my hoodie over my head and looked Dad squarely in the eyes. Fine. I slammed the door as I stepped into the cold night air. I met the guys at the park where we hung out for a few hours. When it was time to go home, I asked if it was possible to sleep by one of them for the night since Dad kicked me out. They all said that they couldn't risk their parents finding out that they were keeping a stranger at their house. That night, I slept in an abandoned building. The next day, the guys pretended that they didn't know who I was, and they told me I needed to take a bath.
He's such a loser,
Blake laughed as they walked away. I spent the next 3 months begging for money for food, sleeping in abandoned buildings and taking food out of the trash as soon as someone threw away their leftovers. I thought I didn't need anyone, but the truth was, I missed my family. Mom, Dad, and even my annoying little sister. I missed them most when I saw families coming to the park on weekends. I woke up one morning and decided it was time to go home. I was grateful when I walked up the driveway and only saw Mom's car in the driveway. I knocked on the door and waited. As soon as Mom opened the door, she threw her arms around me and began to cry. "I'm so sorry, Mom." I held her tightly. She ushered me into the house.
"I'm so glad you're home. Go take a bath, then come to the kitchen to have a proper meal."
With that, Mom bustled to the kitchen. I went to my room, surprised to see everything just as I left it. I showered quickly and ate the meal Mom prepared before crawling into the comfort of my bed. It wasn't long before I fell asleep. I woke when someone grabbed my feet violently. My eyes flew open and my gaze fell upon my dad. He didn't say anything. Dad dragged me out of bed by my legs and into the backyard. Mom tried to stop him, but Dad was a man on a mission.
"You are not allowed inside my house until you've earned your spot. You can't go away for 3 months and come back as if nothing happened."
Dad walked back into the house. Mom got me the tent from the garage. I apologized to Grace, and just like Mom, she forgave me quickly. Dad only allowed me to go into the house to use the bathroom. Mom spoke with the principal, and she agreed to give me one more chance in school. After my homeless experience, I was determined to turn my life around. I even got a job 2 blocks away at a supermarket after school. I gave most of the money to Mom and kept the rest to buy anything that I needed. One afternoon, while Dad was home alone, I headed inside to use the bathroom. After I came out, I heard some grunts coming from the living room, so I went to investigate. When I got there, I saw Dad slumped over his armchair. His hand clutched his chest. Immediately, I rushed to the phone and called an ambulance, then Mom to tell her what was going on. She told me to go with Dad to the hospital and she would meet us there. As soon as we arrived at the hospital, they wheeled Dad to the operating room. Mom arrived 15 minutes later with Grace. We sat in the waiting room, too afraid to talk, too afraid to mention the possibility that Dad may not make it. A doctor entered the waiting room a few hours later.
"Family of Trevor Hall?"
"Yes."
Mom shot up from her chair.
"Your husband is out of surgery. He had a heart attack, which means that we need to keep him for observation for the next few days before we are able to discharge him. It also means that he needs to keep his stress levels down. If Mr. Hall didn't get to us when he did, we would be having a different conversation. You can see him for a few minutes, but then he needs to rest. Mr. Hall, your family is here to see you."
The doctor turned to us.
"You only have a few minutes."
We nodded and the doctor left the room. Mom and Grace hugged Dad while I stood by the door. When Grace and Mom pulled away, Dad asked Mom and Grace if they could give him and I a few minutes to talk. Mom and Grace left, but I didn't move any closer to Dad. Dad motioned for me to come closer, which I did.
"When I was your age, I hung out with the wrong crowd doing petty theft. By the time I was 21, I was robbing banks. Just like you, I was the only one from my crew who got caught, and I spent 7 years in prison. When I came out, I swore to be better, but with my criminal record, nobody wanted to hire me. So I opened my own car dealership. I saw myself in you, and I don't want you to have the same hardships I did."
Tears streamed down Dad's face. I hugged Dad. After a few minutes, the doctor came in and told me Dad needed his rest. Dad looked at me.
"You have earned your place and saved my life. You can come back into the house."
About 2 weeks after his heart attack, Dad returned home. The weeks that followed, I worked hard to build my family's trust. One evening, there was a knock on the door and Mom went to answer it. At the front door stood 2 police officers.
"Good evening, officers. How can I help you?"
"We're here to question Darius Hall, ma'am. Is he around?"
"What do you want with him?"
"We just need to ask him a few questions."
Mom called Dad and I to the front door.
"Good evening, Mr. Hall."
One officer addressed me.
"Over the past few days, there's been a series of robberies in the area. The only place it wasn't broken into is your home. We would like to take you to the station for questioning."
Dad looked at me.
"Darius, do you know anything about these robberies?"
"No, I don't."
"We can sort this out at the station,"
the other officer replied.
"Darius, you stay with them. I'll follow behind and don't answer any questions until I get there,"
Dad said. I nodded and allowed the officers to take me to the station. Dad and a man dressed in a suit arrived at the police station about 5 minutes after we did. We entered the interrogation room and the lawyer, Mr. Mitchell, turned to the police officers.
"Do you have any proof that Mr. Hall was involved in these robberies?" "No, that's why we've brought him here to ask questions." Do you have any evidence leading to Mr. Hall being a suspect in this case?
The officers looked at each other but didn't say anything.
My client will have no problem answering any of your questions if you find proof that he was involved in this. My suggestion to you officers is to go out and find the person who did this instead of placing blame on someone with a past record. For all you know, the thieves were probably going to rob their home tonight and you showed up and scared them off.
We stood up and left the interrogation room. Dad and I thanked Mr. Mitchell and headed home. While in the car, I thanked Dad for believing me and told him how much it meant to have his support. He said that he was serious about giving me another chance, and that meant believing what I said over what other people thought of me. When we got home, Dad filled Mom in on what happened, and I headed to bed. 2 days later, I met Blake at his house. Thanks for the money, B. I really appreciate it.
No problem. I realized that we left you hanging a few months back, and we wanted to do this solid for you.
You may be wondering why I went to Blake's to collect the money. Well, shortly after Dad came home from the hospital, I heard him and Mom talking about the hospital bill. They wanted to take out a mortgage on the house, even though they weren't sure how they were going to repay it. Mom and Dad worked hard to pay off the mortgage so they wouldn't have to worry about having a roof over their head. I couldn't let them jeopardize that, especially after my experience with being homeless. As I sat in my room wondering how I was going to help them, Blake gave me a call, and he told me he wanted to help. I knew Blake and the boys did the robberies. Did I feel bad about what they did? Not really, since no one was hurt. I knew I couldn't give Mom all the money at once because she would question where I got it, so I'm giving it to her in parts. I told her that it's from working extra hours at the grocery store. With Dad under the weather, the responsibility of taking care of my family falls on my shoulders, and I will do whatever it takes to make sure my family has everything they need, no matter what. Am I making a big mistake? Let me know in the comments below.